talking to Mariella Romano. She is Global Brand Ambassador for Arum, for both distilleries. Pleasure to talk to you. Mariella, how did you get into this business?
So it all started when I moved to London 6-7 years ago, and I did like spirits, but I was a bit new to whiskey, and I was working in a bar, and I tried a Lagavulin 16. Never tried much whiskey before, and something happened to me and it changed my life completely, and I thought it was the best thing I've ever tried. I was like amazed and so curious, so I went head in into the whiskey world and I tried to learn as much as possible and taste as much as possible, and I got some very good jobs. I worked for the Whiskey Exchange Shop initially, then for the Scotch Malt Whiskey Society, then I worked as an ambassador again for the Whiskey Exchange Kinder. And the last year in January, I finally got my dream job, and now I work as a global brand ambassador for Isle of Arran Distillers. So I look after the Arran portfolio, and now a little bit of lag as well.
Okay. So for you personally, what makes Arran so special?
Well, there are multiple things. Some things that I knew before, like the reasons why I wanted to apply, you know, and look for a job with Arran, and other things that actually I discovered while doing the job. What always attracted me was obviously the fact that Arran, Isle of Arran Distillers is an independent company. So I like to work for small companies because, you know, they give you the space to be yourself, so there is much more freedom. I can be myself and do this job and share my passion and you know, my love for whiskey in a very open and free way. And at the same time, the liquid was phenomenal, so it was pretty easy. It's an easy sell when the whiskey is very tasty anyway. Mm-hmm. And what I didn't know at the beginning, then I discovered afterwards, was actually how much nature and beauty came into my life while working for Arran. Because I do live in Glasgow, but I'm on Arran pretty often. And for many years I worked for Isla Whiskey, and about the Isla was the dream island, so many beautiful distilleries, so much nice peated whiskey, and I thought it was a great island. But when I went to Arran the first time, I was completely amazed by the landscape, the nature, the wildlife, the people, the community feeling, the multi businesses that live on the island, and they all help each other out. It's quite amazing for a tiny distillery, sorry, for a tiny island to be, you know, so exciting.
So recently you rebranded Arran.
We did indeed.
You also changed liquid a little bit, didn't you?
We did actually. That's the joy of being a small independent distillery. Sometimes, you know, you have to play with the casks that you actually have around. So I would say in general, we could say that the main changes is that this time around, Arran tends to be a little bit more sherried. We used a bit more first fill sherry cask for some of the finishes of our product. Mostly you can see pretty easily with the 10-year-old and with the 18-year-old. We still try to be very consistent, obviously, with the quality of our whiskey. We never color, we never filter. We mostly bottle at 46%. So liquid is still amazing, but if you compare it to the previous batches and the previous products, maybe you'll find a little bit of difference, but nonetheless, it's just very good whiskey anyway. The branding is very exciting for us as well. We have a fresh new look. This year is also our 25th anniversary, so we thought it was time, you know, for a little change as well. And with the arrival of Lag as a new distillery that we opened in May last year, we thought we really needed to divide the two distilleries as much as possible in branding and liquid. So it was a great time for us just to do a big change. The biggest theme that we have with our bottles and the new design is actually water. We have some of the purest water in Scotland, and we're very proud. That was one of the reasons why Harold Curry, our founder, decided to build a distillery in 95 in the first place in Locranza. So there are a lot of water reference, a lot of ripples. The logo with the eagles is a little bit different. It represents the island very well. So looks a little bit more austere, a little bit more important for important and I think beautiful whiskey anyway. So
talking about the differences between Locranza distillery and Lag distillery, how would you describe them?
Well, obviously we're trying to make it as separated as possible. We are very open about, you know, how we do things and how we run things and how we produce our whiskeys. So the main big difference obviously is the peatiness. So As you know, we do a little bit of peated, you know, whiskey in Locranza. We started in 2004 with some 20 ppm. We went on in 2011 with some 50 ppm. They were actually a bit of experiments, you know, for a future lag distillery. But now we actually stopped producing smoky whiskey at Locranza, and we are only focused on non-peated malt at the moment. While at lag, we're going full on. So we use same like Concerto barley from Crisp, but at 50-55 ppm at the moment. Fermentation times are a bit different. At lag, we're doing 72 hours, and Locranza goes from 55 to 110 over the weekend. Mm-hmm. So it's a bit different than that. Stills are completely different in shape, so that affects our whiskey a lot. We have an onion wash still and a lantern spirit still with a line arm that goes all the way down. We really try to create a heavier, meatier, you know, like spirit that, you know, matches perfectly the peatiness as well. So different water as well. We're so proud of our water up in Locranza being very pure, coming from, like, you know, a lock up mountains. But in the lag, we're using borehole, water from a borehole, so it's a little bit harder. But just trying to make it a heavier, you know, bigger spirit, meatier spirit, that obviously has a lot of peatiness coming through as well.
Okay, and to conclude this, two quick questions. You talked about the 25th anniversary.
Yeah.
Is there something planned in special releases you can talk about?
There are a few things planned. I think every market, every country that we are, we're in, is planning something different in different ways. Like, I'm doing a lot of different tastings with a lot of different products. There is, you know, a chance of having something later on in the year, but actually I don't know how much I can say at the moment. Yeah. So it's better if I don't say anything at all.
And final question, if you would have to pick your favorite from the Aaron's we have here, pick it.
So, well, I am a little bit biased because I absolutely love the quarter cask, but I have to pick the 10 because it's the benchmark of our range. Changed a bit this time around compared to the previous 10-year-old, which was mostly bourbon cask matured, first fill refill for like a 70% with a bit of sherry cask. But now we have bourbon and sherry cask vatted together and then finished in first fill sherry. So you can already tell by the color, it looks a bit different. And also age is actually a mixture of 10, 11 and 12 years old whiskey together. So that adds a lot of texture, you know, to the, like, you know, the mouth coatiness and oiliness and character of the whiskey as well. It's still classical Ireland. You still have all the sweetness of the vanilla, the orchard fruits, the honey, the marzipani, like biscuitness. The fruits are a little bit darker, you know, like a little bit like red summer fruits. But I think it's just like a benchmark. It's, I always tell people, don't look at the 10 and then skip it and go to the 18 and 21, which are beautiful as well. But appreciate the 10 because it's a great standard, like a great everyday dram. It never disappoints. Bottle at 46%. It's, you know, sharing dram for any time of the day, I think. It's a great whiskey.
Danielle, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.